Okay, so difference quotient is definitely something that you're going to see in calculus. This actually forms the foundation of something that you're going to learn called a derivative, which is basically a slope of a curved line. So this is one component, one piece of that definition, so it's definitely important to understand how to do difference quotient. So here's the formula. It should look familiar from precalculus. Now part of this formula here is f of x plus h, so I like to do this part of the formula first. So I want to find that for the function x minus 3x squared. So let's do that off to the side. Okay, so if I do f of x plus h, what that means is I have to take x plus h and I need to put it in place of each of the x's. So it's going to look like this. I have x plus h in for that x. I have a minus 3, and then I have x plus h will go into the second one, and I get x plus h squared. So notice what I'm doing. I'm putting x plus h in for each of the x's. I'm not just adding an h on the end like that. That's incorrect. F of x plus h means I put that in for each of these. So let's expand this one. Now you have to remember your order of operations when you do this. So x plus h is the same. Now we're not allowed to take negative 3 and multiply it inside each of these because order of operations says that the exponent comes first. So we want to begin with that part. So I'm going to do minus 3, and then x plus h, I'm going to expand that one. So I get x squared plus 2xh plus h squared. I'm just multiplying x plus h times x plus h together and kind of folding those together to get this one here. And now that I've expanded it, I'm now able to distribute the minus 3. So negative 3, negative 6xh minus 3h squared. This is actually going to be as far as I can go for f of x plus h. So I'm going to take this and we're going to go back to the difference quotient formula and we're going to insert that. So this whole thing right here, that's going to go in place of f of x plus h. So I'm going to do the next line down. I'm going to write that x plus h minus 3x squared minus 6xh minus 3h squared. So I'm going to go ahead and erase all this so we have some extra space here to do the rest of the problem. Now, this part that I did, that was only the first piece, f of x plus h. I'm going to put a minus sign. That minus sign will represent this minus sign here. And then I want to put in f of x. Now, f of x is just the original function. They gave us that one. So I have x minus 3x squared is going to go in after that. And all this is going to be over h. So here's the first part. From here to here, this section right here, that's your f of x plus h. Minus sign would be the same minus sign in the formula, and then f of x would be your function that you have here. So now we want to distribute this. Remember that you're subtracting the entire function, so that's why I got to have parentheses around the whole thing. Okay, so x plus h minus 3x squared minus 6xh, 3h squared minus x plus 3x squared is what I'll have when I distribute that. Now it's important to distribute the negative because now we're going to get some things that we can cancel out on top here. There's an x that's there that cancels with a negative x there. Negative 3x squared cancels with positive 3x squared here. And you're left with, everything you're left with has h's in it. And usually that's going to happen for these kind of problems where you have a quadratic in it. You should only have terms with an h in it. If you get a single number or an x by itself, then you might want to go back and check your work here because you should only end up with things with h left over on top. So I'm going to continue the problem up here instead. So I want to erase this here. So we're left with h minus 6xh minus 3h squared all over h. That's what I have left after I cancel everything else out. What we're going to do next is we're going to factor out an h from the top. And we do this because that's going to allow us to cancel the h that we have down below. You should always be able to do this last step. Whenever you do difference quotient, you should always be able to cancel out one of the h's that you have. So because of those cancel out, I'm left with this is the answer, 1 minus 6xh minus 3h. And this is what you put for your answer. We don't have any special notation for difference quotient. You can just simply write that down on the answer blank. If it asks you for it, you can just put that one in. So this would be your final answer. It's okay to have H's as part of your final answer.